Hey folks, I'm Ravi Kiran Gopalan. I am the co-founder and CTO of Aira Technologies. I'm here at MWC 2025, and I'm going to be walking through what we do at Aira and our solutions. So Aira, we are a full stack AI RAN company. We write software and we provide solutions across the stack. We have a low latency suite of software that specifically focuses on improving spectral efficiency and things that can run at low latency on the servers. And we have another software suite called Navik, where we are collecting all applications and use cases and our apps that can run on the cloud or on a non-real-time rig. And I'm going to be walking through each of those in the next few minutes with you guys. So I'll start with Navik. Navik is our software suite. It's a suite of applications. You can think of it as our apps. You can think of it as applications that run on a SON. And here are a few of them. There are others that are also part of the suite. There's observability, there's anomaly detection and root cause analysis, there's energy management, and we also have a software that can generate and build small applications that can be packaged into our apps and that can be deployed into your SMO or a SON. And I'll be walking you through a couple of these applications as part of this demo. Let's start with the observability platform. And by the way, all of our apps are agentic and GenAI based, so they have a very natural interface with the humans, and you'll see that in the demos. And we are also working with Dell to provide these applications and these software suite as a POC in a very simple manner. It's what we call Navik in a box. It's a Dell server with all our software already loaded into it and also some data sets loaded into it. So if operators want to engage, they can just work with us and get a Dell server and just quickly do a POC with us. So this is our observability platform. You can see the goal here is it's intended for an RF expert to quickly understand what's going on in the network, and the expert can just directly interface with our solution using natural language. Any query that the user types just gets converted to code in the backend, and that code then gets run on the databases and generate solutions. Like for example, the expert could be just looking to understand what is the bandwidth utilization of a particular site. He could just type that using natural language, saying what's the PRB utilization of the sites. Aspects which are natural language will then get mapped to specific components in the database. Let's say it's an Ericsson database, it'll be called by a very specific variable name. So we will do all the mapping, generate code, and run the code in the backend, and then generate whatever plot or solution that's needed. In this case, I'm asking for a plot. So it's generated the code, it's running the code on the database, and it's gonna provide a plot in a second. And it's also providing the code just in case you want to reuse the code for other purposes. And you can see already that site two, there's something strange going on. There's a big loading pattern going on. I want to iteratively query that and understand what's happening. So I could do that. I can say, just isolate site two and so that I can understand it better. It understands what the query is, it's isolating it. You can also do some basic root cause analysis. I'm asking to correlate this against number of users to see is the number of users what is causing the loading on the network. And it turns out that's the case. Number of users has gone up. Maybe there's an event going on and that's what is resulting in increased load on the network. So you could do that all using our observability platform. But let's say you want to take it to the next level. You don't want to keep debugging this issue again and again and again. Every time such loading happens, you want to, let's say, add a new channel or increase the power or something, and you want this to be a very quick application. You could build that application using another product that we have that we call Navik Application Builder. So here the goal is allowing the operator or allowing the RF expert to quickly generate network applications in a matter of minutes. Previously, it's an expert talking to like a data science team or a programming team, and it takes couple of months at least to get an application out the door, but that is not good enough. We want this to be agile. So the goal here is to use Gen AI and the code writing capabilities of Gen AI to be able to generate our apps in a matter of minutes. So this is a platform to design, develop, test, and deploy our apps. So all you have to do as a network expert or an RF expert is to define the application that you want to create using very simple flowcharts. And within the flowchart, there are logical blocks. And these logical blocks can be written, again, using very simple natural language instructions of what this block needs to do. And our backend, we have an SLM that converts each of these applications into specific parameters and instructions and code. So what is happening in the backend is each of these blocks is getting converted to code, and all the code is getting stitched together to represent this flowchart as an application. So that's what's happening here. It's generating code, it's stitching together the whole flowchart together. And once the code is generated, how do you know if this code is doing exactly what this flowchart is intended to do? Because this was a code that was written by Gen AI. So that's where our testing feature comes in. We use Gen AI once again to generate a series of tests that can validate that the code that was written is actually accurate. So here you can see it's a simple code that's meant to change the tilt under certain interference conditions. And you can see that once the interference conditions are met, the tilt actually changes. So you can verify that the code is actually doing what you're supposed to do. And once you're comfortable with it, this code can then be part of your GitOps. It can be then sent out for someone else to package it. If the operators want us to package the code into an RApp, we can do that too. So there's multiple ways of using this platform and quickly generating applications. So that's our application builder. But beyond these simple observability and applications, we also have sophisticated RApps that we build from the scratch and provide as just pure applications or RApps for operators to consume. One example is our anomaly detection RApp. This basically looks at all the KPIs that the network is providing. And let's say an operator has a meta metric that they are detecting anomalies on, we can then correlate those anomalies with all the underlying KPIs and provide a fingerprint of exactly what's going wrong with the network, which then can be used in the next step, which is our root cause analysis RApp, which is taking these fingerprints, not just your metametric, not just your top level metric that's going wrong, but the underlying suite of metrics and the suite of KPIs that are also going wrong that form a fingerprint, and that fingerprint can then be correlated against suggested root causes, suggested solutions, and that's what our root cause analysis RApp is doing. And we also have an energy management RApp. So these are the suite of sophisticated custom-built RApps that we can provide to the operators. And in this, the energy management RApp, essentially we are predicting the loading and key KPIs of every cell on a per cell basis, and using that to decide which cell or which radio to shut down. And before we shut it down, we also have an action effect predictor which tells us what will happen if I shut down this cell. Is it going to affect the QoE? Is it going to affect the throughput? And if those parameters are benign, then we optimize and shut down the right kind of cells. So this is something that we are POCing with an operator in New Zealand called Spark. And you can see these are the KPIs that we are tracking, number of UEs, bandwidth utilization, and we are predicting these KPIs. And we are also, you are allowing the user to select, or in this case, the operator to select how much degradation they want to see. And based on that, we are shutting down these cells. You can see there are a number of cells that are being actively shut down based on the parameters of the application. So that's our Navik suite of applications. It's a suite of RApps that can be consumed. It's a combination of sophisticated RApps as well as an application builder that can be used to build simple applications on the network. This is our low latency software suite. essentially mainly used to improve spectral efficiency of the network, and we do that by using machine learning to predict how a channel is going to evolve, both in time as well as in frequency. And by using that better predicted channel estimates, we can do improved beamforming and improved multi-user MIMO, and that improves the spectral efficiency of the entire system by almost 30%. And we are again working closely with vendors, Open RAN vendors, to bring this into production. So thank you. This is what we do at Aira, and we'd love to hear from you guys and happy to engage. If you want to learn more about Aira technologies, you can go learn more from our website, www.aira-technology.com. That's aira-technology.com, and we'd love to hear from you.